Let's start with chapter number 5. So today I would be covering some important questions related to arithmetic progression. So let's start with question number 1. So in this we need to find the ninth term from the end of the AP. So we are given with AP 5, 9, 13, ... so on till 185. So here in this case you have to consider A has the last term, so it will be 185 because I would be going from the back. So my first term will be 185 and D be my, so before 185 we must have 181 because the difference between 5 and 9 is 4, so the difference must be 4. So 181, take 181 then 185, so the difference will be minus 4. Then we have to write n as 9 because it says ninth term we need to find. So as you know the formula, an equals a plus n minus 1 d. Then an in this case is 5 because the last term here is 5. Or you can, as we need to find ninth term, so I would be taking n as 9. So that my a9 is equal to a, that is 185 plus n is 9 minus 1. D can be written as minus 4 here. So 185 take away 32, which equals 153. So therefore you can write that ninth term from the end is 153. Now moving on to question number 2. It says for what value of k will k plus 9, 2k minus 1 and 2k plus 7 are the consecutive terms of an AP. So as you know that it is in AP form, that means how to find D. D is actually A1 minus A or A2 minus A1. You can take any two values. So my second term is 2k minus 1 and subtract the first term, that is k plus 9. So 2k minus 1, opening the brackets, so minus k, then the second bracket minus 9, because minus plus is minus. So 2k take away, k is k, then minus 1 minus 9 is minus 10. So the difference here is k minus 10, which equals now we need to find for this one, for the second one. So D will be here A2 minus A1, that is 2k plus 7 minus 2k minus 1. Now it will be 2k plus 7 minus 2k plus 1. So 2k and 2k gets cancelled out. So it will be 7 plus 1, which is 8. So here we get the exact value as 2k, 2k gets cancelled out. So therefore, we get the value of D here. Now we need to put the value of D in equation number 1. Let it be equation 1. So D is 8. 8 equals k minus 10. So you can take minus 10 on the other hand. It will be 8 plus 10. That is 18. So k value in question number 2 is 18. Moving on to next question, question number 3. So it says how many terms of the AP 18, 16, 14 be taken so that their sum is 0. That means we need to prove that my sum is 0. So as you know, value for sum is, or the formula for sum is n over 2 in bracket twice of a plus n minus 1 d. Now sum is 0. We don't know about n here, n over 2. So 2 into a. A here is 18 plus n minus 1. D in this case will be 16 minus 18, that is minus 2 in bracket. So 0 equals n over 2 in bracket 36. Minus 2n, solving brackets, minus 2n and plus 2. Later on, you can write it as 0 equals n over 2. 36 plus 2 is 38. 38 minus 2n. So you have to solve this using cross multiplication. So 2 will come over here. So it is 0 equals n. 38 minus 2n. So n is again 0. 1 times 0. Then we have other value as 38 minus 2n. Equals 0. Now you have to solve this. 38 equals 2n, so n equals 38 over 2, which is 19. This is question number 3. Now moving on to question number 4. It says fourth term of an AP is 0. That means my A4 is 0. Or you can write A4 as A plus 3D equals 0. Now we need to prove that the 25th term, that means A25, is 3 times 11th term, that is A11. So this is what we need to prove using this equation. So from this, from equation 1, we can get value for A. A is minus 3D. Now here they talk about A11. So I will be finding A11 value first. So A11 can be written as A plus 10D, or A can be written as here minus 3D. So 10D minus 3D equals 7D. Now we need to find the value for A25, because we need to prove that A25 equals 3 times A11. So A25 can be written as A plus 24D, and A here can be written as minus 3D, minus 3D plus 24D. So 24D take away 3D will be 21D. Now A25 equals, now how to split this such that to make it thrice of 11th term? So I can write it as 3 times 7D, and 7D is equivalent to A11th term. So you can substitute the value of 7D as A11. So this is what we need to prove. These are all important questions from previous year. So you must do them. Now moving on to next question, question number 5. It says, if the sum of the first 7th term of an AP is 49 and that of the first 17th term is 289, find the sum of first n terms of the AP. So we are given with S7, that is 49. S7 can be written as n over 2 plus in bracket 2a plus n minus 1d. So n here is 7, so 7 over 2 in bracket twice of a plus n minus 1, that is 7 minus 1, then we have d equals 49. Now using cross multiplication you can solve this. So 2 will go here and 7 will go at the denominator on the right hand side. So 2a plus 6d equals 49 into 2 over 7. So cutting down 7 with 49, it will be 7. So 2a plus 6d equals 14. This is equation number 1. Now the second one, it says that of its first 17 terms is 289. So sum of 17 is 289. Similarly, we can make the equation for S17. So it will be 17 over 2 in bracket twice of A, 17 minus 1D equals 289. Now again using cross multiplication method as we did in the first case. So 2A plus 16D equals 289 into 2 over 17. Now 17 and 289 can be cut down, so it will be 17. 17 into 2 is 34. So this is equation number 2. Now we have to solve these two equations and find the value of A and D here using elimination method. So let's solve it out. 2A plus 16D equals 34. 2A plus 6D equals 14. So subtracting the values, you get 10D equals 20. Or you can write it as 20 over 10, which is equivalent to 10. That means my D is, the difference between two terms in this AP is 10. Now we need to find the A value. So putting the value of D in equation 1. So 2A equals 14 minus 60. Sorry, this will be, D will be 2. As you cut 2 over 10, so this will be 2. So putting the value of 2 in equation 1, so it will be 14 take away 12, which is 2. 2A over 2 will be, A will be 1 here. So my A is 1 and my D is 2. Now we need to find the sum of first n terms. So let's find out Sn in this case. So Sn in this case will be n over 2, 2a plus n minus 1 d. Now n will be as it is, a value is 1, n is as it is again, d value is 2. So it will be n over 2 in bracket 2, 2n minus 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled out. We have n over 2 and in bracket we have 2n. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled out. We are left with n square. So Sn in this case is n square. Moving on to question number 6. It says Reshma wanted to save at least 6500 for sending her daughter to school next year after 12 months. She saved for 450 in the first month, raised her saving by 20 every next month. How much will she be able to save in next 12 months? Will she be able to send her daughter to the school next year? So in the first month, she saved 450 and she raised her saving by 20. That means 470 in the next, 490 in the next and so on till 12 months. Now D in this case is 20, A in this case is 450 and she has to save 6500. Now we have to find S12. S12 is the sum of 12 months. So 12 over 2 in bracket twice of A plus N minus 1, that is 12 minus 1 D. D in this case is 20. So 12 over 2 can be cut down and can be written as 6. So 2 into 450 is 900 plus 11 into 20 is 220. So 900 plus 220 is 1120 and 1120 times 6 is 6720. That means she can save 6720 in 12 months. So she will be able to send her daughter to the school next year as she need at least 6500 as her saving to send her to school. So therefore, yes, she is able to send her daughter to school next year. Now moving on to question number 7. So in an AP, if S5 plus S7 equals 167 and S10 equals 235, then find the AP where Sn denotes the sum of its first n terms. We need to find the AP, and that's all we need to find AP here in this question. So S5 can be written as five over two then in bracket twice of a plus n minus 1. N here is 5, so 5 minus 1 is 4d plus s7. s7 can be written as 7 over 2. Then twice of a n minus 1, that is 6d equals 167. Now solving further, so it will be multiplying 5 over 2 with both the values, so it will be 5a plus, then solving the next 5 into 2 into 4, so it will be 10d plus 7a plus 7 into 3, that is 21d equals 167. So 5a plus 7a is 12a, 10d plus 21d is 31d equals 167. So this is my equation number 1. Now moving on to equation number 2, we need to solve s10 equals 235. So s10 can be written as 10 over 2 in bracket 2a plus n minus 1. N minus 1 here can be written as 10 minus 1, so 9d equals 235. So 10 over 2 can be cut down and can be written as 5. So 5 into 2 is 10a, and further 5 into 9 is 45. 45d equals 235. This is my equation number 2, but I can simplify this as 3 numbers are the factor of 5. So here you can simplify it and write it as 2a plus 9d is equal to 47. So this is my actually second equation. Now again you can eliminate a or d by elimination method to find the value of d and a. So I will be multiplying second equation with 6. So 12a plus 31d equals 167. And the second equation is 12a. 6 times 9 is 54d equals 6 into 47 is 282. So 23d equals 115. And my d will be 115 over 23, which can be written as 5. So my d is 5. Now we need to find a value again. So a value from equation 1, you can write 12a plus 31 times 5 equals 167. So 12a plus 31 times 5 will be 155. 167. 167 take away 155 will be 12. So 12a equals 12. That means a is my 1. So a is 1, d is 5. Now we need to form ap of it. So ap for first term is 1, second term will be 6, next term will be 11 plus 5 is 16, and so on. So this is my AP. Now moving on to question number 8. So it says the 13th term of an AP is 4 times its third term. So that means A13 equals 4 times of third term, that is 4 times A3. So 4 times A3. Now the next line states, if its fifth term is 16, that means A5 is 16. So let us solve this first equation. So A13 can be written as A plus 12D, and A3 can be written as A plus 2D. Now solving this equation, we have A plus 12D, and on the other hand we have 4A plus 8D. Now, solving A on the left hand side and D on the right hand side. So we have 8D minus 12D. So minus 3A equals minus 4D. Now minus minus gets cancelled out and A value will be 4D over 3. So this is equation A. This is equation 1. A equals 4D over 3. Now, as you know, we have A5 equals 16. So A5 can be written as A plus 4D equals 16. So A plus 4D equals 16. Now putting the value of A in this equation, it will be 4D over 3 plus 4D equals 16. Now taking LCM. So after taking LCM, we have 4D plus 12D over 3. Equals 16. Now 4D plus 12D is 16D over 3 equals 16. Now 16 and 16 gets cancelled out. So we are left with D equals 1 times 3, which is D equals 3. Now putting the value of D equals 3 in equation 1. So we will get the value of A as 4. So 4 times 3 over 3, 3 and 3 gets cancelled out. So we are left with A equals 4. Now we need to find the sum of first 10 terms. So we need to find S10. Now S10 can be written as 10 over 2 in bracket twice of A, that is 4, plus N minus 1. N here is 10 minus 1 into D, that is 3. So 10 over 2 can be written as 5. 2 times 4 is 8. 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 into 3 is 27. So 5 into 8 plus 27 is 35. So 35 into 5 is 175. So sum of first 10 terms will be 175. Now moving on to question number 9. It says the first and the last term of an AP are 8 and 65 respectively. So we have A and we have AN, or you can write it as L, 65. If sum of all its term is 730, that means SN is given to us. SN is given to us is as 730. Now we need to find the common difference. So SN equals N over 2 in bracket A plus L. We have to use this equation, this formula. Why? Because we are given with L value. So SN, SN is 730 here. N is unknown to us, N over 2. A is 8 and AN or L is 65. Now solving this equation, we get 730 equals N over 2 in bracket 8 plus 65 is 73. Now using cross multiplication, we get N equals 730 times 2 over 73. 73 and 730 gets cancelled out and we get 10 times 2. So N equals 20. That means we have 20 terms in it, but we need to find the common difference. So for common difference, we have to use AN formula. AN equals A plus N minus 1 D. AN in this case is 65. A in this case is 8 plus N in this case is 20. 20 minus 1 D. So 65 take away 8 equals 19D. So 65 take away 8 is 57. 57 over 19 equals D. So 57 and 19 can be cut down. So D will be 3. Common difference will be 3. So that's your answer for the question number 9. Now I have another question similar to question number 9. So it says first and last term of an AP are 5 and 45 respectively. If the sum of all its term is 400, find its common difference. So the question is same as we done in the last question, as a last question, question number 9. So comment down the answers below in the comment section. So that's all for this video. Have a great day and continue with the practice of mathematics and all other subjects as you wish. Have a great day. Thank you for watching this video.